10:30 last night.
Outside Rockwell Snooker Club?
In the car park.
Not easy to get run over in a car park, is it? Witnesses?
No.
Ian McKendrick, eh?
You've heard of him?
Boy wonder.
He scored that goal on Saturday.
So I gather. It would be a blinder, would it?
He was out of this world.
I thought it might be.
He's just 17. He's been tipped for the national side next year.
Sergeant Beach.
And this is Detective Constable Carver.
He's had a rough time in theatre, so if you don't mind.
Of course.
He went under a wheel.
So what's the damage?
Right tibia, broken in two places, bad fracture of the left femur.
So how bad's bad? He scores goals.
Not anymore, I'm afraid. He'd been drinking. Excuse me.
Ian McKendrick? I'm Detective Sergeant Beach, and this is Detective Constable Carver, Sunhill. And you are? Hey, you are?
His girlfriend.
And your name is?
Sally Parker.
Can you tell me what happened?
Take a look.
You were picked up by the ambulance outside Rockwell Snooker Club at 10:30 last night. You'd been in the club.
Tell me about it.
You'd been drinking, I'm told.
Gonna do me for underage.
Are you gonna tell me what happened?
He doesn't know, does he?
How bad is it?
I'm not a doctor.
They won't tell me.
You've no idea what happened?
What happened? What happened? I don't know what happened.
And we also need a list of your employees. What do you mean you're giving us one? Who? Oh, DS Beach, right. Okay, this is it, I think. Plain paper, preset dialing, error correction. 1,500 quid. It is.
How are you getting on with that, Rod?
Yeah, hang on, please. Yeah, brilliant, sir.
Well, if you need a hand, give me a shout.
No, no, I'm fine. I'll get this lot sorted by Christmas.
Look, Sergeant Beach is doing something else. Now, have you got a problem with that?
No, sir.
Good.
Well, he was celebrating.
Silly little prat. You tried telling him that.
So who was on the table with him?
That teammate of his, what's his name? Waring, Mickey Waring. Do you want one?
Yeah, why not? Trouble that malt, eh? So, what went wrong?
She came in.
Who's that?
No, on me.
Oh, cheers.
Girl, 18 or 19, haven't seen her before. Short, blonde, good looker.
McKendrick's girlfriend?
There's a hell of a row. Pack it in, I said, or you're all out the door. Waring slings his cue down and walks.
What about the girl?
Nah, she goes with him.
What time was this?
About 8:30. McKendrick stays here till 10 o'clock, getting out of his skull. Won't listen to anything. When I say that's your lot, I'll get a mouthful of abuse. I'm not having that. I don't care who they are. I'll call him a cab and shove him out in the car park to wait for it.
So what about the cab driver?
No, he comes strolling in when it's all over.
Sergeant. A call came from a box around the corner. The operator said it was a girl. Hysterical.
What, no name?
No. It's a bit early, isn't it?
McKendrick's girlfriend, Sally Parker, says she wasn't here last night, right?
And was she?
Looks like it.
Mickey Waring? He'll be in the changing room. Mickey? There's a couple of coppers to see.
Thanks. Hello, Mickey. I'm Detective Sergeant Beach. This is DC Carver, Sunhill. You're Ian McKendrick's mate, yeah? Best mate, right?
Well, that's right. We're in digs together.
Known him long?
We got signed the same week. We look out for each other.
Ian got the winner Saturday. Ace strike. Well, it don't go any better. Top corner, curled it round a keeper.
I hear Ian was at Rockwell Snooker Club last night. Were you there with him?
We had a tenner on a couple of frames.
Yeah? Who won? You didn't finish. That's right, the manager gave you the bum's rush.
Don't talk to us, Mickey.
Ian went a bit heavy on the sherbet.
You had a row, right?
Who told you that?
What was it about, Sally Parker? That's the girlfriend, Nicky. She came in, remember? Are you still with us?
Well, I got a knack for it, ain't I? Getting between mates. Look, we're not getting at you. We just want to know what happened.
We hear that you left Rockwell's with this Sally Parker. Do you take her home?
She don't like it when he's on the bevy.
I don't think the fans would either.
She told him to stop. You ever told a Jimmy to stop drinking?
Where does Sally live?
Well, I thought you took her home.
Bagford Roadway.
Do you know where she works? We want to question her.
In a deli off Elcott Street. Yeah, I've got to go, all right.
Catch you later, Mickey.
I don't believe it. He didn't ask who his best mate was.
Well, Detective Sergeant Beach spoke to you. He said you were sending us a list of your employees. Oh, it wasn't you. Well, who was it, please? Well, when can we come down and speak to your driver? Well, why not?
This, Ian McKendricks is the business, yeah?
Best I've had in 10 years. Hospital reckons he might not play again.
He's been with you for about 3 months, right?
Yeah, we brought him down from Scotland.
Now that goal, sad.
Oh, magic. Edge of the box, drew the keeper.
Curled it into the top corner.
What about, Mickey Waring?
Yeah, he'll make a decent striker. In time.
He didn't make the team Saturday?
No. What the hell's he after now? Gary Lowry.
What, the agent?
That's him. He's been after Ian ever since he came down. Bloody vulture. I get sick of him hanging around. Boss ought to kick him off the park.
Well, why doesn't he?
Well, they're all part of the game now. Getting the claws into kids, making them greedy. I'll leave you to it then.
Yeah, cheers.
Thanks.
Boss, call me in 6 months, I'll have a look. Police, Mr. Lowry. I'm Detective Sergeant Beach.
Okay, are you walking my way for a reason?
Ian McKendrick.
How is the lad? I hear it's his legs.
Yeah, you hear right.
Now, why didn't he come to me?
You're after him?
Was. Had Ryan Giggs written all over him. He'd catch his cull on Saturday. Out the top drawer. Drew the keeper out.
Curled it into the top corner, yeah. Did Ian turn you down, Mr. Lowry?
Correct.
And why was that?
He wants his father to look after him. What happens? He gets rat-arsed in some snooker club.
Hmm? How do you know that?
It's my business, don't I? Abby?
So that's the great Gary Lowry.
Just another prat and a merchant.
You know him?
Heard a few stories. Yeah.
The fax machine, Sarge.
Yes, Rod.
Well, who did you speak to at the warehouse? Because I still haven't got a list of the drivers. And is someone coming in with it?
Look, is your little backside stuck to that chair? Can't you get off your brains and sort it out?
Keep me posted on your progress, Rod.
Yeah, it's very easy, sir. Nothing.
Don't play silly games, Rod. You're no good at it. What's your problem?
Sally, we need another word.
Sorry, 1 minute. Claire? Can you just, carry on here? Okay, do you want to come round the back? This way. Right. What do you want? Because I can't leave the counter.
You lied to us, Sally. You said you weren't at Rockwell's snooker club last night.
What happened to Ian? Have you found out yet?
Why did you say you weren't at the club?
Because it was my fault. It was my late night working. I knew exactly what Ian would be like. I wasn't going to go down there. But I got a bus down. So if I hadn't have gone...
There wouldn't have been the row. And you wouldn't have walked out with Mickey Waring, right? How does that make it your fault?
Because then Ian carried on drinking, didn't he? And he would have drunk himself stupid.
We've got Ian staggering round the car park with a skin full. Somebody have the hump with him.
Why don't you tell us, Sally?
All right, Mickey.
I thought Mickey took you home. You say you went back down to the club.
In the car, he said he always fancied me. And then he started mauling me. And then he got my hand, and he pulled it across on, you know. Go on, he said, I don't mind, feel free. And so I told him to stop and I would tell Ian. And then he just went mad and he banged my head on the car door and then he shoved me out of the car.
He never took you home?
He said he was going back to the club to see if Ian was all right. We watch each other's backs, he said. So I should have known. And it isn't what everybody says at all, it isn't. He hates Ian. He hates his guts.
Hello, Mickey. I said I'd catch you later, didn't I? Spare us a minute.
I'm on a winning streak.
Over there.
I've still got 50 credits.
Have you?
Your story this morning, you left the bit out of the end. You know, where you dump Sally Parker and go back to the snooker club. Pick up Ian.
That isn't right.
You took Sally home, right?
Yeah.
You didn't go back to Rockwell's.
Oh, is that what she's saying?
You didn't try to get your leg over in the car. You did.
I just said I liked her.
Yeah. Well, you're a real little gent, Mickey.
Are you saying you didn't go back to Rockwell's?
No.
You haven't seen Ian since then. You haven't even been to the hospital to see him, have you? You're not his mate, are you?
Not fair, is it, Mickey? Agents chasing Ian. Your time will come. Coach told us.
Fick Pillock.
Yeah?
Slagging Mr. Lowry off. To his face and all.
Where was this then?
At Rockwell's, last night.
Well, Mr. Lowry was there?
Said he'd give Ian a last chance to get on his books. Reckoned he could get him on. 750 quid a week.
Tempting, eh?
And he'd had me one of the big clubs in 6 months.
So what did Ian say?
He called him a ponce, didn't he? Mr. Lowry was white. He was shaking. He was so mad.
All right, Mickey, come on. All yours.
Ian was asking for it.
And aren't you going to bring him in?
Who, Lowry?
No, Mickey. He's jealous, he's been blown out, and he's trying to put Lowry in the frame.
Maybe.
Oh, come off it, Sarge. Do you really believe that Lowry would have broken the kid's legs because he wouldn't sign up?
How many agents do you know, Jim? Most of them would cut their grandmother's throat if she crossed them. Yep.
Did you get a list of the serial numbers for the fax machines?
Yeah, they're in a blue folder.
Oh, you did? Right, where is it?
It's on my desk, Rob.
Well, no, it isn't.
Or perhaps it's in one of the drawers. There's three of them.
OK, which drawer?
I don't know. Look in all of them, eh?
Right, the blue folder.
That's the one, yes.
Now, is the list complete?
So how many have you got, then?
Well, how many were nicked?
24.
Well, 24.
Right, is that it? Eat your heart out, Mincer.
Susie.
Yeah?
Our snout on Elverton Road.
What about him?
Well, he's been a bit quiet, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Well, this is right up his street. Office supplies. And he'll be on his lunch break.
Mr. Lowry.
I could get your title for him in a year.
Yeah. How can I help you?
Not interrupting anything, are we?
I'm always open to the constabulary.
You saw Ian McKendrick last night?
Correct.
You were at Rockwell Snooker Club?
I was.
Did you go there to see the boy?
I was there to cheer out one of my snooker lads. He's playing a quarter final next week. Did you think it was just soccer? Lowry's top flight sports agency.
Did you talk to Ian?
The boy was drinking too much. Criminal talent he's got.
You gave him a last chance to get on your books.
Correct. After Saturday's goal, he was going to be hot property.
But not yours.
He's worth a lot more than his own. I'll get him a proper contract.
He turned you down, Mr.
Okay, stop it right there. I left the club with a chauffeur at 10 o'clock. At 10:30, I was having supper in the West End.
I'll check.
The restaurant was a Bella Rosario. The head waiter's name's Luigi, and my guest was a boxing promoter, Frank Morelli.
Right. Jim, do the honours, will you?
What have I done to you, Sergeant? I play hard. I play to win, but I stick to the tram lines. Your people know that.
Which people are these?
I'd rather not be involved in your inquiries. Things stick in this game. Ringside seats. The big fight at Wembley, Saturday. They're like gold dust. No hard feelings? Like I said, I'm always open to the constabulary.
I can see you.
Listen, Ian McKendrick's a cocky little toe rag, but he didn't deserve that.
No?
He was giving his girlfriend a hard time.
How's that?
Lager doing the talking. When I left the club, she was driving back in. Volvo Estate.
Right.
What the hell are you playing at? I'm trying to help you. Do you know how much they cost?
I'm sorry, Mr. Lowry. It's Saturday night. I forgot. It's curry night, isn't it? Takeaway. Video. Feet up. I'm sorry to bother you. I'm DS Beach, and this is DC Carver.
Hello?
Sun Hill. Sally Parker, please.
Why? What is it now?
Look, I'm sorry, Mrs. Parker, but we are going to have to speak to your daughter. Thank you.
Sally? It's the police! In here.
Right, thanks.
She's told you everything.
Well, not quite. The Volvo estate parked outside. Is it hers?
Her father's.
Does she use it?
Oh, we don't like her to. It's too big for her.
Was she driving it last night?
Oh, I don't think so.
You see, Sally was seen driving a Volvo estate into the car park at Rockwell's Snooker Club about 10 o'clock last
night. What would she go back there for? Him from Scotland? She's finished with that little tyke. And that other one. You know what he tried to do getting her into his car? She's too good for them.
You get in the front, yeah?
Hello, Joseph.
What is it?
Come on.
I can't see you like this.
And don't make it long.
Don't hang around here.
Right. The fax machine's from Canley Street Warehouse. Joseph.
You make a proper appointment.
I'm out of time and there are 24 of them on the market.
How do you know?
I can smell them.
I told you, Rod.
Yeah. Whenever you want something, they never come across, do they?
We drop him.
Right in it.
The only reason your boss doesn't know about your little sidelines is because we choose not to tell him.
Listen, Joseph, I'm going to find these machines. And if I have to do it without you, then there's no reason for me to keep you on board.
Oh, come on, Rod. We're running out of time.
Okay.
They're going for 500 notes.
Sierra Oscar from 85.
Go ahead, Narika.
Can you confirm the vehicle Sergeant Beach wanted was a light blue Volvo registration Hotel 508 Victor Tango Hotel?
Confirm.
Right, it's now going down St. Hugh's Road. Stopping outside the hospital. Female driver now going into the main entrance.
Okay, you know, don't you? Okay, I'm just telling him, all right? I've got to tell him first.
Why don't you tell all of us?
Ian, what I'm trying to say...
I've said it would take 12 months. I won't play again.
It was me, okay? I came back to the club. Do you know what Mickey tried to do? I came back to warn you about him. Okay, and I came back to tell you what he tried on.
What happened?
I drove into the car park and I was trying to back up. And it was really dark, Ian. And then he was just there behind me. And I felt the car go over something. And I was going to tell him this morning. I was going to tell you this morning.
What?
I couldn't. It was me. It was my car. I did it.
You what?
It was me. You were right behind me.
You?
What were you doing there? What were you doing there? Can you see me? No. Not in your state, you stupid Burke. It wasn't my fault, okay? You hear? It wasn't.
Look, it was an accident, right? Your parents allow you to use the car, there was no traffic offence, and you dialed 999 immediately, yeah?
That's right.
So why didn't you tell us this morning?
That's what it was. It was an accident.
You wasted my time.
And you tried to implicate Mickey.
John.
Can you give us a minute, Gov?
Now. Can you do this, Jim?
Sure.
It's the McKendrick case, Gov. It was an accident. Girlfriend. Jim's taking the statement.
Well, I've just had a call from Gary Lowry's top flight sports agency.
He says he's been harassed by you. Inquiries, Gov.
He was at the snooker club.
He's not involved.
But he wanted to sign the boy badly.
Well, he said he went in like a bullet a gate, hadn't done your homework.
Did he now?
Is it something personal?
No, Gov. He'd have tried it on with any of us.
Tried what on?
He thinks I fell off a Christmas tree.
Well, that's not all, Don. You've dropped Rod right in it.
Gov?
He's had no chance with this Canley Street warehouse investigation.
Right. I'd better see how he's getting on, then.
Sarge, the fax machines are turning up from my snout.
Nice one, Rod.
Yeah, two on Oxton Road and one on Dunford Street. I think it's a sports agency. It's called Top Flight or something. Should I get a couple of search warrants?
No, never mind about that. You got the serial numbers?
Yeah.
Right. Catch you later, Gov. Come on, let's go.
Come to apologise, Sergeant.
Always was impetuous.
McKendrick business sorted?
Yeah, nice one.
So, what are you after?
You're always open to the constabulary.
Correct.
I could swear that's one of those new faxes that we're interested in, Rod. Preset dialing. Plain paper. Error. Correction.
Bingo.
Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Looks like an own goal, Mr. Lowry.